Let's say people want to get into their first investment property. What are some advice you got for them in terms of cash flow, debt, projecting what they're going to be doing in the future, all that kind of advice?
Yeah, look, you know, one of the things that we use for with clients before they enter a negotiation is what I call a property investment analysis.
Yep.
It's a computer program which you plug in all the details about the purchase. People can buy it. It's from Summersoft Financial Services in Queensland. It's $500. You just pay for updates when there's changes to tax laws and rates and all that sort of stuff. And you plug in all the details, the purchase costs, the ongoing cost, it's got a CPI rate in there, and it tells you exactly down the bottom how much a property is going to cost that investor to hold for the next 10 years.
Yeah.
So it could say $72 a week. If you can afford $72 a week and that's the purchase price you're willing to go to, and try and negotiate up to or below that price. And if you get below that price, it's going to be a better outcome from that $72.
Mm-hmm.
So if you can get hold of something like that, it's a really great way of going into a situation with your eyes wide open, fully researched, making sure that it's something that's achievable, it's not going to impinge on your lifestyle too much, because you still want to be able to do other things. Don't go in too small when you're buying a property. Go and don't be afraid of spending a little bit more, because it's going to usually be less of a hold cost and a better financial return in capital growth.
Get a high
in the
quality.
Long term. Better quality property. If you go and buy a one-bedroom apartment, chances are in 10 years' time, you may have made 10%.
Yeah. There you go, folks. Do your research. Make sure you know how much you're going to be spending on a weekly or even monthly basis. Make sure you can afford it. And probably most importantly, don't be shy to get in. If you're in a position where you can do it and you keep holding on, you're never really going to start growing your wealth even from the start, as long as you don't overpay.
Yep, that's right.